Hi all, today's tutorial has been asked by many of you, so I've decided to make this a priority after completing all my GDS courses videos. If you have any friends or colleagues just getting started with Data Studio, feel free to introduce them to these videos. They are super beginner friendly. Now, let's get started with today's video. In today's video, I'll be sharing with you two ways to create a custom date filter using calculated field. So the first one would be a year filter, and the second one would be based on a custom date range. Some of you might be asking, why do we need a custom one given that we already have a calendar control to filter the data? Well, in some cases, the date range filter here might be overkill and users may find it difficult to learn how to use. So the developers want to simplify the experience of slice and dicing the data with a custom date range. For example, if I want to filter this dashboard to year 2020 only, I may have to go to this filter and search for the relevant options, or I may have to go back to 2020 and select the month January, the first day of January, and then I have to select 2020 last month, December, and select the last date. So I'm not sure how many clicks we have done just now, but it's just not so user-friendly and it's a bit time-consuming. So one of the options is to custom make the date filter so that it's more intuitive for users to use. Basically, for the year filter, users can select a year from the filter and the rule will be applied to every chart instantly. For example, I'm choosing 2022 now and all the charts will be showing the data in the year 2022.
Similarly, the date range filter also allows a specific
period of time. So for example, if you are doing campaign analysis, you may want to look at pre-campaign, what was the statistics be like, and during the campaign day, what is the performance, and after the campaign, what is the status of the sales. So here are some of the possibilities that you can do with this custom date filter. So if this is something that you're interested in, let's get started. Okay, so now we are going to create a custom year filter. To do that, we'll first need to add a drop-down control. So we'll go to the toolbar at the top and click add a control, then select drop-down list. Click on the canvas to add the filter. First of all, since Data Studio has selected sales date for us, what we're going to do is just to change the aggregation type for this sales date. So to do that, we'll go to the control field, make this bigger. Go to the control field and then we will click on this edit button next to the control field we have. And then in the window under the type, we are going to change this date to year instead. So just select the year. And here I'm going to rename it as custom year filter. After we do that, now when we click on this filter, it will show us 2021 and 2022, which is the data that we have in this data set. Say for example, if I choose 2021, you can see in this time series chart, I can only see data from 2021. Whereas if I click on 2022, you will only see the data from that year. So that's what exactly we want, which is pretty simple by just changing the aggregation method. Other than this method, we can also use a calculated field to achieve the same thing. Say if I add a control, and then under the available fields, I actually have created one custom year filter for the same thing that we just did. So here I'm using the year formula to derive the year part from this date field. So if I drag in this field into the control field, you can see that here we have the same options created similar to what we created using the first method where we're just changing the type of the date field. Before I move on, if you like the content so far, please help to support this channel by hitting the like button. Thanks for your support. Now let's get back to the tutorial. Next, we'll build the custom date range filter using a calculated field. Let me go back to the demo earlier. So for the demo purpose, let's assume that our campaign is on 11th of November. And then we want to define a range before the campaign and after the campaign. So now what we're going to do is to go to create a new field. Just click on this add a field at the property panel. And under this field name, I'm going to key in custom date range filter. And then we will start by defining our campaign date. So I'll use a case when, since we have a few conditions here. Case when the sales date, it's on 2021 in the month of 11 and the day of 11th, I'm going to call this campaign day. And here, what we're going to do for Data Studio to recognize that this is a date is that we're going to add a function called date. Then we will end this function, the entire case when function, with an end clause. So wait until we see the green tick and we can click save and finished. Now, what we're going to do is to add a control. And then we're going to drag in the calculator field that we just created into the control field. Now, when I check the values inside this filter, I can see this campaign date. So let's go ahead and test this out first. So I'm going to click on this only and see what is the date range in this chart. As you can see, the date has shown on 11 of 11, so it's correct. Now we're going to go ahead and add in the other date ranges that we want. So I'm going to make this the second one. And I'm going to start the first one as the date range pre-campaign. So for pre-campaign, I want to show you if let's say I want it to be within a date range of 2021, October and day 10. This is 1 month before the campaign. And here we can use 10, because we don't want to include this date. Or you can remove the equal sign, and here where you can just use this one. Now we have done with the condition statement. Enter, then we want to call this group as pre-campaign, and then we can indicate the date range. Oops, I forgot this date formula. All right. So now I've seen this screen tick. That means that my formula is correct. And the last one would be post campaign. So same thing, we're going to use the when. And then it's more than when the sales date is more than the date 2021, 11. So we are going to call it as post campaign. Okay, so wait for this green tick. Now I'm going to click update and finish. Sorry, now when I click on this date range filter, I am seeing three different options. including the now, which is before we specified the pre-campaign, I believe. So let's check it out. Yep, it's correct. So it's before 10:10. So I'm going to ignore that because it's just an example. So right now, if I click pre-campaign, I should see the dates appearing here within the specified period. So we are using 10:10 as a starting date. So we are seeing all these dates are within what we have specified. And then for campaign day, it's the correct one. Same for the post campaign, we can see that it's after 11:11. So it seems that all of the filter has been functioning correctly. And with that, that's all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you find it useful, don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel. If you wish to contribute to my channel, feel free to buy me a coffee, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.